Is AI in a bubble right now?
I do not believe AI is in a bubble. What I do think is on the enterprise side, it is going to take a while for large corporations to prepare themselves to transform. It's going to take a company like Palantir going into the largest enterprises and really restructuring them in order to really capitalize on the productivity gains that we think are going to be unleashed by AI. In the consumer space, the consumer loves all of this, you know, and I think we're all looking forward to our personal assistants doing our shopping for us. Well, I am. As I talk to people around the world, some people love shopping, so they may not. But I am really excited about not just shopping, but how much my productivity as an individual is going to increase with AI. It already has in terms of research.
Let's just stress test this point, because you said that AI is not in a bubble, but you also flagged that there could be a correction risk. What's the timeline on that correction then, if you were to gaze into your crystal ball?
I think we're going to reach a moment in the next year where the conversation will shift from lower interest rates to rising rates, but it will be for a good reason. We think that the economy, the US and the rest of the world, of course, will participate, is going to move into a productivity-driven boom just in time for our midterm election. So I think when interest rates reverse, there will be a shudder, because there are a lot of people out there, and we saw this during COVID and its aftermath, who think that innovation and interest rates are inversely correlated. That is not true over history. Even in 2017, when interest rates went up, we had phenomenal performance. So I want to disabuse people of that notion, but nonetheless, the way algorithms work these days, we think that there will be a reality check, shall we say.
How should investors be thinking about allocating in the innovation space? Of course, we look at ARK, up more than 50% YTD. Talk to me about some of the allocations you're making right now and this big bet on the future. Ultimately, what's going to pay off?
Well, one of the things we have focused on consistently is, really, this is going to sound almost silly, but we're focused on the future, and pure plays in the innovation space around robotics, energy storage, AI, blockchain technology, and especially multi-omic sequencing in the healthcare space. I think that's the most underestimated and underappreciated. So those are our five main areas. They involve 15 technologies, and we think they're converging to create really explosive growth opportunities.
What do you think has changed in the market that is rewarding your strategy again? Because I also think it's fair to say, since our last conversation in Abu Dhabi a couple of years ago, you've been through a pretty rough patch, right?
Yes, we went through a very rough patch. And in fact, during the 4 years prior to this administration, we were facing increasing regulation, a massive increase in interest rates, supply chain shocks, all of which impacted unit growth. And unit growth really drives innovation. And the faster units grow, the faster costs decline. And so we're through that. And more important, in this administration, we have with OB3, the One Big Beautiful Bill, massive tax changes that are going to take the effective corporate tax rate in the United States down to what we believe is 10%. Statutory will still be 21, but with the accelerated depreciation, massive accelerated depreciation in manufacturing structures, equipment, domestic R&D, and software, we think that that is going to turbocharge innovation in a way that people do not appreciate right now. And that is one of the reasons we do believe we're moving into next year. We'll see this idea of a productivity-led boom in activity.
Because I want your reaction first and foremost to this surge that we've seen in Qualcomm. It's going to be taking on the likes of Nvidia and AMD. Your thesis is innovation. Do you welcome that pop? Is it just getting started? Where is it going from here?
Yes, I know a lot of people are worried about all the AI hype. But as we're looking to the future, especially with embodied AI, which is all about robo-taxis and transforming the world of transportation completely, and then healthcare, which is probably one of the most profound applications of AI, we think that this investment will pay off. And I think the chaser is going to be humanoid robots. And I think that is going to be the biggest of all the embodied AI opportunities. Mm-hmm.